Everybody have a seat. I have props today. I have to get ready. Okay, you're going to be amazed at this. Can everybody see? There are two or three really good artists in my family, and I'm not one of them, which will be obvious here. But before we do this, I want to ask you, Christmas has a lot of wonderful songs, doesn't it? Oh, and let's bring Lily out here so everybody can get at her, okay? Right there. While we're doing that, what are some of your favorite Christmas songs? Besides the one you just sang. Yes, dear? Jingle Bells. Always a winner. Yeah. Happy Birthday, Jesus. And I'll bet you can sing that. I bet you know all the words. You have a solo in that one? You mean like next Saturday? I'm going to be there. Yeah, yeah. Oh, Night Divine.
I like Jesus' Christmas birthday.
I love that too. Yes. Let It Snow. Well, I'd love to hear you sing that one. Yes, dear.
Silent Night.
Silent Night.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
You know, that has been my favorite for so long. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Yeah.
March of the Sugar Plum Fairies.
March of the Sugar Plum Fairies. Now we're getting cultured here. I'm sorry. There's so many, aren't there? And nobody mentioned one of my other favorites, We Three Kings. Does anybody like that one?
I never
heard of that. Never. Well, I'm not going to sing it today. Well, part of it, because I really like the part that goes, Oh, Star Wonder. See, some of you know that. Go ahead, dear. Stop. Sing it with me. Okay. All right, never mind. I shouldn't have stopped. Okay. Well, I want to talk about a star for a minute. And I started my painting over here, and you may not be able to tell, but this is actually the stable where the manger and Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus is right there. Okay, and these are the three wise men on their camels. You know, I told you I wasn't the artist in the family, okay? But anyway, the point is not these things. By the way, these are just regular stars out there, but then there was the star, right? Everybody say with me, the star.
The star.
And what star am I talking about? Anybody? Yes, dear?
The star that led the wise men to Jesus.
The star that led the wise men to Jesus. We actually see it on our picture there on the screen, don't we? And now let me just ask you, if you were doing this picture, where would you put that star? In the sky, it's going to be in the sky up here somewhere. And where exactly? Where would you put it? Over here? Okay, right here?
No, there's a spot over there.
Okay, well, if you were drawing it, you would put it right here? Okay, is that right? Okay. I learned how to do these stars in first grade. Okay. Where would you put it here?
Right here.
Right here, okay. Is it big enough? Am I making it big enough? Okay, one more. You know, who else? Would you put it in a different place? Where would you put it? Come show us. This may be a while. Y'all just hang it. Right here? Okay. All right, one more, Owen.
In the corner, maybe?
In the corner here, this corner?
Yeah.
Okay, I've got a little symmetry going there. I like it. Here's the thing. Do you know what the Bible says in Matthew? That the wise men saw the star. And the Bible actually says it rose, which means, you know, it came up out of the horizon, but it wasn't there the night before. That's the thing. All these stars have been there for a long, long time. And then the star we're talking about arose. It had been seen for the first time. And these wise men... Yeah, that's Jesus right there. I'm sorry I didn't draw him any better. But it says more than that. It says that it went on before them until it rested. In other words, it was moving. Now, here's what I want you to know. People say, that can't happen. That's not the way stars act. That's not the way stars work. And I would say this, who's painting the picture? Right? Because when you were painting the picture, you got to put it anywhere you wanted, didn't you? And nobody could say, you can't do that, because it's your picture, right? Owen, isn't this star your star? And didn't we put it there because that's where you wanted it? Right. Well, listen, the whole universe is God's picture, right? So he can put a brand new star any day he wants to, any size he wants to, and he can make it move if he wants it. Why? Because it's his what? It's his picture. Exactly. And, you know, it reminds us of something, actually, that the angel Gabriel said to Mary. When the angel told Mary, even though you're not married, you don't have a husband, you're going to have a baby. And she says, how can this be? This is amazing. And do you know what he said? With God, nothing is impossible. Will you say that with me? With God, nothing is impossible.
Impossible.
Amen. That's all I have to say about that. Okay. Well done, children. Good job. Father, thank you so much for the ones we learn about the God of the impossible.
After
not only is all powerful, great and majestic,
before
but
Christmas,
who loves each one of them with an everlasting love. In Jesus' name.